Hey everyone. Hey, I got something exciting to show you. At least it's exciting to me. Over here in the pheasant coop. Check it out. First I gotta turn off the electric fence here because sucker pokes you really good. Alright, let's go in. Okay, so I'm gonna make this quick, but there's the rooster right there. Look at how nice he looks. Alright, and the hen's right behind this pile of hay here, so alright, check this out. Check it out, guys. They're laying eggs. The pheasants have laid eggs underneath this thing my wife piled up here. Some hay and some old corn stalks. And you can see one didn't quite make it into the nest here. We're hoping maybe she'll pull that in eventually, but right now there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and the one sitting out here. Yeah, these guys aren't happy behind me, but I hope you can see those there. It is so cool. So we're hoping now we're going to be able to hatch a few of these. Probably leave some out here for the pheasant to hatch, and then we'll probably take some in and incubate them so we're sure that they hatch. So we're not sure how much longer she's going to be laying eggs. She'll lay an egg a day, and until she gets a certain amount, up to around 10, maybe more, and then she'll sit on them. So we're not sure when that's going to start, but I'll let you guys know. I thought that was pretty cool. All right, I got something else to tell you guys. All right, so we're down here in the studio I've been telling you guys about. It has dual monitors. These are 23-inch LEDs. They're pretty nice. They make it really easy to do editing. And it's part of the control panel for my mixing board. This is the computer. Thing is a monster. Weighs like 50 pounds. It's just amazingly heavy. But it's really cool. It's got some LED lights in it and stuff. A bunch of fans. It's an i7. It's a 2600K, so it's unlocked, so I can overclock it. It overclocks really easily, so it's a pretty cool computer. Alright, so here's my microphone that I use. It's a Studio Project C1. Working on a new project right now. You guys will hear that soon enough. And then I use the headphones here from Pheasants. They came with my software package. They work pretty well for recording. And then I have this, it's called a mud guard. Keep the reflections down from the wall behind. And makes it sound dry, which is good for when you're recording vocals. You want to be able to add stuff later, not have anything added before. So, and then that runs into my voice processor here. It's a HHB Radius 40. Basically, it's a tube preamp right here. You can see the tube in there. I don't know if you can see it lit up, but I replaced the tubes. They have 1957 RCAs in there with the long black plate. They really do sound nice. There's three of them in here. So you have a compressor and the equalizer, and then you have your output controls here, and you can watch your meters here. You can link these together. You can have two of them if you're going to do stereo. So basically I record everything pretty flat. I don't do much here, just a little bit of compression right in here. Turn it up just a little, just in case I get a little loud. I don't want it to clip. And then I have the input set pretty high, so I get a lot of tube drive. I think it gives kind of a more warm tone. So then I have some more stereo equipment down here from my youth, and I don't use that much. Sometimes I use it to listen to the song once I get done mixing it. But and I run everything through the KRK Rocket 8s. These are really good. Monitors, 500 uses the a little smaller one, but they're the same type, so I wanted to be sure I got the same thing he had. And then so basically get back to the computer here. I use Studio One for my recording. Let me show you how that looks. Okay, so there's the software up. On the left side is the main screen where the vocal goes, or I also have the music on that side. You can see there's a vocal. That was the Steppenwolf vocal. I go through and edit it on this side. And then over on this side is all of the mixer controls where I can add reverb and delay or whatever I might, some compression maybe, whatever it takes, a little EQ. And but most of the work gets done over here, removing breaths and things like that. It's kind of tedious, but it is kind of fun to go through and edit out a vocal. It's kind of interesting how it all works out. So all right, so I wanted to tell you one thing about the YouTube video that nearly killed me. So during the Born to be Wild video, I had my wife with me, and she was helping me videotape all the scenes from the truck. She was holding the camera while we were driving and that kind of thing, and holding the camera when I was driving out and, you know, driving away and to and for and whatever. She was always the one holding the camera. So you gotta remember, this is a 1955 Chevy. It does not have seat belts. So here we are driving along, and let me just show you what happened here, and then I'll explain it to you. Alright, so let me explain. See that guardrail on the right? Alright, well, basically, I had no steering. I came around the corner, I was going up, trying to go into that slight bend there in the road, and the truck just kept going to the right, and the steering wheel was completely disconnected from the wheels. I was not able to control the truck at all. And so I panicked and I stabbed the brakes so it wouldn't hit the guardrail, and when I did that, my wife flew forward. Luckily, she grabbed the dash. She set the camera off right at that point, and the truck basically swerved to the left and went over the center line and ended up over there on the side where the grass is on the left there. Luckily no cars were coming, so I was able to get out and assess the situation without any damage. Yeah, so basically what happened was the steering linkage came apart. There's a big U-joint that comes off from the steering wheel all the way down into the past the firewall, and then there's a shaft that goes into that U-joint, and what happened was the shaft actually came out of the U-joint and was laying on the frame, and that's what connects the steering wheel to the steering box. And my brother and my dad had actually put in a power steering system about 2 years ago, so apparently something wasn't tightened all the way, which were the two set screws. Turned out all we had to do was get Master Outdoorsman out there with a couple of Allen wrenches, and we just found the right one and put it on there and tightened everything back up again. So the truck was fine, everybody was fine. I'm just glad it didn't happen up on a road. Could have been doing 50 miles an hour, 60 miles an hour, you know, and had that come apart on me, and there was absolutely no control of the truck. When you slam the brakes on, it pulls to the left really hard, and that would have been pretty dangerous, especially if I hit some oncoming traffic. So we were pretty lucky that we were in that park. The park's only 25 miles an hour, so you know, all the video you saw that I made of driving, those were all 25 miles an hour, and I just sped them up 300x, and you know, makes it look like you're doing like 75 or 80 miles an hour, which is kind of cool. So like I said, I'm just really glad that everything worked out. You know, my wife and I were okay, and we're able to get the truck back together again. And I hustled it right over to my dad's garage and put it away. I didn't want to be responsible for anything going on with that truck. So what we're going to end up doing is, probably next weekend, we're going to take one of the set screws out, and then we'll drill a hole all the way through, and then put a nut and a bolt. That way, it'll never fall off again. So it was pretty harrowing, and you know, it could have been extremely dangerous. So anyways, that's the YouTube video that nearly killed me. So thanks for watching, guys.